What's good, everybody? It's your girl, Madison Sims, back at it again with another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how I achieved this roller sit.
They were like, "Pop, why you all like that? Why you tall like that? Why you all like that?" I'm off at Eddie, I'm up.
So something that I didn't mention in the intro is that I am going to be dyeing my hair jet black using the Dark and Lovely 371 Jet Black color. I find that this color really brings out a vibrance and shine in the roller set once it's complete. The next two items that I'm going to show are completely by preference. I choose to use Lotta Body when looking for a mousse, but it really doesn't matter whose mousse you use. And the curlers are from a local beauty supply store, but as long as you have rollers, you'll be set. At this point, I'm just taking down some twists that I had done a few days prior to this video, and this is me setting up for the dyeing process.
Why do we keep doing that?
Okay.
Once my hair was parted into four equal sections, I started to apply the dye down each section. And in order to make sure that the dye is evenly distributed through the hair, I kind of finger quilled the dye through my hair to the ends. Once I finish applying the dye, I hop in the shower and rinse it out. There are several different techniques to rolling hair, but I always tend to roll underhand when I'm working with the back of my head and even at the top of my head. So I just repeat this all over. So this is what my head looked like completely covered in rollers, and I'm gonna let this sit overnight and show you guys the results the next morning.
The next day.
So this part is completely optional. Whenever I separate my curls, no matter the style, I tend to use an oil, and coconut oil ends up being the oil that I use, but it just prevents me from causing any unnecessary frizz that may happen if I were not to use an oil. So that's just what I choose to do. Now that all of the rollers are out of my head, I begin to separate the curls just by running a finger down the middle of one large curl, and it separates it, creates more volume, creates more bounce, fluff, and it just makes the look more full.
Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light.
I almost always go back in with a pick just to create more volume and to separate the curls just a little bit more without disrupting them the way that fingers can. So this is the final look, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video.